At midday, he reached his father, who received him with great joy. "Well, my dear son, what hast thou learned?" said he to him. "Father, I have become a joiner." "A good trade," replied the old man, "but what hast thou brought back with thee from thy apprenticeship?" "Father, the best thing which I have brought back with me is this little table." The tailor inspected it on all sides and said, "Thou didst not make a masterpiece when thou madest that. This is a bad old table."
"But it is a table which furnishes itself," replied the son. "When I set it out and tell it to cover itself, the most beautiful dishes stand on it, and wine also, which gladdens the heart. Just invite all our relations and friends. They shall refresh and enjoy themselves for once, for the table will give them all they require."
When the company was assembled, he put his table in the middle of the room and said, "Little table, cover thyself." But the little table did not bestir itself and remained just as bare as any other table which did not understand language. Then the poor apprentice became aware that his table had been changed and was ashamed at having to stand there like a liar. The relations, however, mocked him and were forced to go home without having eaten or drunk. The father brought out his patches again and went on tailoring, but the son went to a master in the craft. The second son had gone to a miller and had apprenticed himself to him. When his years were over, the master said, "As thou hast conducted thyself so well, I give thee an ass of a peculiar kind, which neither draws a cart nor carries a sack." "To what use is he put, then?" asked the young apprentice. "He lets gold drop from his mouth," answered the miller. "If thou settest him on a cloth and sayest, 'Bricklebrit,' the good animal will drop gold pieces for thee." "That is a fine thing," said the apprentice, and thanked the master, and went out into the world. When he had need of gold, he had only to say, "Bricklebrit," to his ass, and it rained gold pieces, and he had nothing to do but pick them off the ground. Wheresoever he went, the best of everything was good enough for him, and the dearer the better, for he had always a full purse.